has the Bitcoin price right now bottomed out? Well, I believe there is a very high probability that we are about to see a major uptrend here in the coming few days moving forward that could potentially bring us back all the way to about $42,000. And I'm long right now on Bitcoin, Ethereum, and even Dogecoin. I kid you not, I'm even long on Dogecoin. So based off this chart, I'm going to tell you guys what my strategy here is moving forward. So definitely watch this video till the end, because yeah, there will be some absolutely amazing information shared in this video. And of course, make sure to sit down, relax, and let's get into this video. All right, so I think for certain, at least for now, Bitcoin has bottomed out. And I don't think that there's any certainty that Bitcoin is going to break autumn high again in the coming months. But I do think there's a very decent probability that at least here in the coming few days and weeks, we are going to be looking at a nice uptrend to the upside. So in the Telegram channel, you can see that this message right over here. I talked especially about three levels that I was watching. And first of all, I'm going to talk about all of these levels here and why I believe that they still could be hit. But personally, as you can see, we went here to the $28,000 level. And I said, if we get a very strong bounce from this level, then this would likely indicate that we have bottomed at least for now. And the reason for this scenario is that this is actually a pattern that we did quite a few times here back about 1 to 3 years ago. So basically, to understand what this pattern exactly is, we have to look at the BitMEX funding rate. And in the last 2 years, every time that the price had a correction, the price went sideways and the BitMEX funding rate was negative. This indicated that the price was about to have a reversal again to the upside. Sometimes the price actually went up, but we still came back down. But at least mostly, when the price went sideways throughout negative funding, it indicated that the price was about to have a reversal to the upside. And yeah, you can see it right now, exactly the same thing playing out. And the reason I talked about this $28,000 level is actually because this is a very common fractal that played out a few times here in the past. So as you can see here, we had this move here to the downside, and then we went sideways. We had a fake out to the downside before we had this major move here to the upside. Same thing played out right over here. Again, negative funding, as you can see, negative funding, negative funding. We broke here to support. We failed to break further to the downside. We had a move here back to the upside, and this indicated a new uptrend to the upside. Again, both examples, the price still came back to the downside. So if we look right now at the current price level, you can actually see something very similar. Again, we have negative funding rate. We came back down, we broke support, we wicked back up, and right now we are setting a double bottom pattern. So this appears to be, again, that exact same fractal, which could indicate that at least for the short term, we have bottomed out. But again, I'm saying here for the short term, because we still have a major resistance to break. But again, as shown in the past, sometimes these moves to the upside, they can just be giant bull traps before the price actually gets a new move to the downside. So we have to look at a potential target where we can exit our long, or we can sell a little bit of our portfolio if we are very uncertain, so we can potentially protect ourselves or even make money when Bitcoin gets a new correction to the downside. And this is why I talked about this hedge moment around $42,000. If we get again to this level, I believe that is the moment where I will exit some of my positions. I will potentially go as well a little bit into stable coins. Depends a little bit on what the stock market is doing as well. But at least if we break to that level, I'm going to definitely hedge myself against a potential second correction here to the downside, which could be, you know, something that maybe goes as low as $24,000, but it could as well still bring us down to these very big levels of $20,000 or maybe even $40,000 if we see some kind of a global correction and cool down as well on, for instance, the stock market. But this is something for later. I don't think this is really important. We still have to look out at what the price actually does here at the $42,000 level. If it breaks it with big volume, if we see the stock markets continue to rally, then yeah, we could of course see the price as well still reverse here back to the upside. The reason I'm looking here at this $42,000 level is because of the 38.2 Fibonacci level. And the last two times that we had a blow off top here, we went to the 38.2 level before we had a new move here to the downside. And again, this is where you wanted to sell. This is where you wanted to hedge. And if you actually did that, you could buy more back here at the bottom. And as well over here, this blow off top, we went to the 38.2 level. If you sold here a little bit, you could buy more here back at the bottom. So the $42,000 level is a very important level. If we fail to actually break this, then yeah, this could still indicate that we are going to be looking at a second move here to the downside to some of the targets, which I've drawn right over here. Now you might actually want to know, why are these two targets very important? Well, first of all, I believe that if we go back to about $20,000, that would be an amazing buy opportunity. I think that if we see a second pullback to the downside and we don't see the stock market have some kind of a crazy correction, that is the most likely target that we will go to. At that point, we will as well have a one-to-one correction from the top here to this wick here to the upside. So that would be, again, about a one-to-one correction. Probably a very likely target if we don't get kind of a major stock market correction. And then the best possible buy target, that is down here around $14,000. Now, this looks like a very horrible target, but if I pull the Fibonacci tool here from the top to the bottom, this would be about the 84% level. And this would be the target where every bear market mostly finds support. As you can see here, back in 2015, it found support right over here around the 84% level. And back here in 2019 as well, it found support around this 84% level. So the worst possible bearish scenario and the best possible buy moment is, in my opinion, the 84% level. Now, are we going to get this? Well, back here in 2018, the reason partially why we had this correction is not only because Bitcoin was extremely overbought, but also because the stock market had a correction at that time. And back in 2014 and 15, the dollar index rallied quite a bit, which as well was very bearish for Bitcoin. So we have to see some kind of a stock market crash, or we have to see the dollar pumping for these really low targets to actually get hit. In my opinion, I think I talked about everything. I will be looking to sell a little bit, maybe even short a little bit, around $42,000. If we fail to hold that and break further down, then 20,000 will be my buy target. If the stock markets as well get a correction or we see the dollar pumping, my buy target will be around $14,000. Now again, keep in mind that these videos are not financial advice and anything is open. You know, we could see Apple adopt Bitcoin. We could see the United States start to buy Bitcoin. Anything can happen in this space. So of course, do your own research. That's very important. This is just my personal plan. And if we do break higher above this $42,000 level, I would likely buy back my Bitcoin. And I'm not selling 100% of my Bitcoin. Again, this is a hedge, which means that I do expect a further continuation to the upside, but I would de-risk my position a little bit if we get to these high levels to protect myself against a potential crash to the downside. And these levels over here at $14,000 or $20,000, they might look very low, especially if you are new to crypto, but these are very normal levels where Bitcoin goes before it actually finds enough strength again to start a new bull market to the upside. These bull markets, they take multiple years, and it's unlikely we're just going to moon back to the upside out of nowhere, especially after we did have quite a big pullback here to the downside. So be careful about any scenario. Don't try to buy tops. Don't try to sell bottoms. I think overall, crypto is going to go still to very high levels, but I'm protecting myself against a potential crash because I definitely believe that it is on the table. But any dip that you're getting, this has been very proven in the past, is a big opportunity. Do not forget that. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to like and subscribe and join the free Telegram. The link is in the description, and hope to see you guys in my next video. Bye bye.